The state opposition is risking its credibility by spruiking a leak of a major legacy building project for outgoing Premier Mike Rann, his longed-for city tram loop. Reporter Alan Murrell joins us now live. Alan, the government says the opposition leader's bought a one-way ticket to Fantasyland.
Yes, they claim that she has been taken for a ride, but Isabel Redman insists that a high place source has tipped her off that the Premier tomorrow would announce a $100 million plan to extend the tram from here at Victoria Square down Gugger Street and then back to North Terrace. The game plan is to present a Premier obsessed with his legacy, a ruling party obsessed with settling scores by leaking information. The danger always was, of course, that the government would simply postpone the announcement and leave the opposition with egg on its face.
The opposition is confident it has a direct line to a Rann government source leaking like a sieve.
We understand that the government is about to announce a $100 million extension of the tram line.
According to the Liberals, the news was to come in the outgoing Premier's final speech to the Property Council tomorrow. Mike Rann has made little secret he wants the tram to run down Gugger Street and link back up with the line at North Terrace.
Very realistic. It's going to happen. Absolutely.
But a government which can't afford $75 million for the Darlington Interchange project, a key part of the expressway duplication, says there is no current plan for a city loop tram. The Transport Minister says Ms Redman might have been set up.
Isabel Redman has been spooked by some internal comments, and I'm afraid she's got a bogus leak. Now, this is something we've seen before in the Liberal Party.
Isabel Redmond insists the leak exists and is evidence of a divided ruling party at war with itself. But if no tram announcement comes from Labor, then the Liberal announcement could backfire, reviving painful memories of the so-called dodgy documents which cost the previous opposition leader his job.
Well, I guess tomorrow will show how good the source is, but we are fairly reliably informed.
Alan Murrell, 10 News.